Good morning. I think I'll just have a seat. Let's try it again. Good morning. If you noticed anything different this morning, I was sitting in the middle of the worship center, just seeing if anybody would come by and visit me. And I had about 12 different people come up and say, "What are you doing here?" They didn't tell me where I was supposed to go, but they wondered why I was there. We're glad you're here. It's a unique Sunday. Our projectors are not working today, so if you want to sing the songs, we may just sing the first verse and the chorus of the two hymns we have. One of them is Blessed Assurance. You should know that one. And the second one is Victory in Jesus. Now, we do have one projector in the back that's working. So if you want to turn around and sing the songs with the words, I can't stop you. So this is a day that we celebrate. We are sending about 30 people to church camp at Camp Lakewood today. So that's pretty amazing. And that's all been from the generosity of you. We've asked that you help cover camp expense for campers. We have 20 campers and 8 youth and adults that are going to help this week. I know Pastor Susan's already there coordinating things. Had to make some changes last minute for staff. But God has a plan. You know, things don't always happen the way that we think. For instance, we planned on doing an open house for Leona Anderson this afternoon because she will be transitioning to Tennessee to assisted living near her daughter, Judy. But Leona's not feeling well today, and we've got cake and punch, and we're going to eat it. So after worship, for you online people, just visualize eating a piece of cake and having some punch. But after worship, you're invited to do a late breakfast, early appetizer for lunch. There are also a sign-up book that you could sign, write a note in there and say hello, how are you, miss you, bless you, or whatever you want to put. And then there are also tabs of her new address that we'd like for you to take and send her a note and flood her with your love. Okay, the other announcement I have, we want to pray for our projectors because that's kind of awkward and different. But also, this is the week we're supposed to be paving the parking lot. Now, it's supposed to rain 2 out of those 3 days. So I want to ask you to help me. Now, a lot of people think that I've got a lot of power. I'm sales, not management. So I can't control the weather. I can just ask God for assistance. So, Lord, I know we need the rain, but could you have it rain around the parking lot area so we can get that done? Anyway, that's this week. So we're asking you to minimize your coming in to the office. So if you need one of us, email, text, call, send a voicemail to the answering machine. We'll check that periodically. But we're trying to stay away from the church to give enough space for people to get that done. Hopefully, it will be done this week. Do you believe in the power of prayer? Okay, so pray really hard that we're able to get that done. So, any other announcements I need to share today? I know there's a golf scramble coming up at the end of August. You may want to sign up for that. It's going to be at Falls Creek Golf Course. And be ready to play. I think it's $65 per person. So, okay. Anybody have a birthday this week? Rex? All right, would you stand if you have a birthday this week? Okay, so Pam, Norma, Rex, and Jane. Wow, so I'm not going to ask who's the youngest. We'll just leave it at that. So let's just sing a very fast happy birthday. Ready? Now it's fast. Ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God loves you. Happy birthday to you.
You all were awful. Just thought I'd let you know. We are First United Methodist Church Ministries. We are two campuses, you caught me. One mission, one vision, two campuses, Pendleton and Ingalls. Let us focus on worship.
It's so wonderful to hear Shirley on the piano. Thanks again, Shirley. What a beautiful way to set the mood and me ruin it. It's just going to be a tough day here. There we go. Anyway, good morning, everyone. We are so thrilled you're here today. We are going, and welcome back to Ryan and Jay, who have been traveling the world and Ron joining us today. We're just mixing everything up. So we're thrilled to have everybody here today. Please stand, and if you would like to show off your other side, you may turn and watch and if the words, because this first song we're doing, Beautiful One, you may not know the words, but just as you please, main thing, lift our souls to heaven and let's worship and have a great time loving our Lord.
Nothing on earth is as beautiful as you. You open my eyes to a wondrous anew. You capture my heart with this love. Because nothing on earth is as beautiful as you. Beautiful one, I love you. Beautiful one, I adore. Nothing on earth is as beautiful as you.
Amen, amen. And God has showed me such a wonderful thing. You people are just as beautiful from the backside as you are in the front. You people are beautiful all the way around. Let's continue in song. I'll bet you know this verse, blessed assurance, the first and the third. If not, the rule is always smile, lip sync, and you'll be just fine. And you can sit, you can stand, you can lay down, whatever you like.
This is my story.
my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect at last. I am my Savior, and happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in
I know you know that last part so well. Shirley, would you give us a chord? We are going to lift the roof, sing it a cappella. Help us out, fellas. Here we go.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
God's always got a plan, doesn't He? He's always got a plan. That was beautiful. Let's continue with another incredible old-time hymn, Victory in Jesus. Let's hear that chorus one more time. Let's do that chorus again. Here we go. And
in Jesus, my Savior forever, He sought me and bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is to Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood.
You know, it is amazing how the struggles that you go through, everyday life, you get ups and downs, you get bumps in the road. Well, you don't usually expect that in the worship experience, but we've had it today. But the wonder of it all is it can't take away from the Spirit that's in here in this place. No matter if it's an unintentional mic drop, or whether the projectors don't work, or whether we had to face opposite way, just so you know, that's a first for me, to see the congregation in full turn your back on the pastor It's okay. So when it all comes down to it, really doesn't matter, does it? Because it's unimportant. But the Spirit is important to us. So thank God for being patient with us in the midst of this. Because I think God has a plan to make it even better today than it has been. We're asking that the children stay in worship today. A lot of our teachers are at camp already, or will be going there. So I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for loving the church and giving of your time, talent, gifts, service, and witness. Thank you for the ways that you express yourself. You know, we have young people that have volunteered their time this summer to do extra care and extra help with camps. You know, they were asked and they were willing spirits to do that. There's been a huge need of people volunteering this year, and some of our folks have stepped up to that, to be that. So thanks be to God for that. Also want to thank you for just being you. Just the way you share your faith and your love. Continue to be that way. When you do contribute, you have the opportunity to do that online. We have offering boxes in the back of our worship center. Ordinarily, I say bring your offering to the church this week. Mail it, please. Because we're trying to do the parking lot, trying to stay positive. But we do want to thank you. Also, before we begin in a time of prayer, I just want to bring up Marilyn Crosley to you. Marilyn is having some health issues, and just pray for her and the family. She's home. But just pray for Marilyn and Jim and the family. And I know when they say, I say family, that's like one third of the congregation. But just remember them in a time of prayer. And there are other people that I'm aware of that have had physical situations. Some have had surgery recuperating. Others have tested positive for COVID and just found out a couple more today. So I'm just going to ask you, be careful and be safe out there. And may God continue to pour out God's love to us, each one.
Are you hurting and broken within? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. My Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was brought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
So the invitation for you this morning, that song seems appropriate for me to offer this to you. I call these communion rails or prayer rails. Some people call it the altar. I'm going to invite you that if you have a need, that you just feel the need to come and kneel and pray, and that's, you're welcome to do that. You're under no obligation, but every once in a while, I feel like the Spirit moves us in a way that we need to honor. So as we focus on prayer and have a time of prayer, and the song continues to play, after I pray, the song will continue for a little bit longer. But I don't want you to feel rushed or pushed in any way. This is your time with God. Let us pray. Oh God, we come to you this morning. We come to you today for prayer, for reassurance, for affirmation. I want to lift up Mary Cloud, whose brother John passed away earlier this week. Pray for Mary and for peace and comfort in a time of grief and loss. We pray for those who are experiencing uncomfortableness in this world. Lord, we know that there's an increased rise in suicide, or at least attempts. And we pray for the Holy Spirit to come and be upon people and let them feel that there is a sense of hope in this world. And there is an answer to the discomfort and the hurt and pain. Oh Lord, we come to you in the name of Jesus, just asking for you to be with us. Sometimes we feel like it's very, very hard to be a Christian in this world because the way the world treats one another. But we also know that it could be very easy if we just learn to follow you. Help us, oh Lord, to be a people of faith, to trust in you, to honor the love, to be connected in the Spirit, so that we are truly a witness. Lord, we come to you again, asking for your blessings, and help us to pray the prayer that you have taught us to pray and say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Behind your regrets and mistakes, come today, there's no reason to wait. Jesus is calling. Bring your sorrows and trade them for joy. From the ashes a new life is born. Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness, the blood with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, what a sin. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was brought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. isn't he wonderful? Sing hallelujah, Christ is risen. Bow down before him, for he is Lord of all. Sing hallelujah, Christ is risen.
Sing with us.
Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was brought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen, Ryan. We are so blessed, and we're going to continue this incredible spirit. I am so thrilled to welcome Carly Kellen, who will be playing violin this morning, and her grandmother, Charlotte, is going to be accompanying her. So come on up, and we are just going to continue being so blessed by God with your talent and music.
Thank you.
Did you notice that both of them smiled after they finished? They were intent. That was wonderful. Thank you very much. So in order for me to get the point across today, I need your participation. I need your help. So it's not that hard. You can do this if you choose. And if you don't want to, then, well, okay. So I want you to get up. Now, this may be unique for your online worshipers, but I want you to get up and shake hands or wave to three people that you haven't spoken with this morning. You got it? Okay, now I don't want you to take a half hour because I still want to preach. So get up, go, do three people. Okay, there was a number of three. Some of you went extra beyond that, and that's okay. I'll give you a pass. Some of you are still doing it, and it's time to stop. So my first question is, what does it take to be a Christian? You'll hear that after you hear the scripture. Taken from Luke chapter 6, verses 27 through 36. Hear the word of the Lord. But to you who are listening, I say, love your enemies. Do good to those who, I don't like this word, so I'm going to change it. Despise you. I don't like the H word. Bless those who curse you and pray for those who mistreat you. If someone slaps you on the cheek, turn them to the other also. Now remember, you actually have four cheeks. Think about it. You got it. Unfortunately, it's probably the only thing that you'll remember out of this message. And I say, thanks be to God. Okay, let's move on. If someone slaps you on the cheek, turn them to the other also. If someone takes your coat, do not withhold your shirt from them. Give to everyone who asks, and if anyone takes what belongs to you, do not demand it back. Well, that's interesting. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners do that. And if you lend to those from whom you expect repayment, what credit is that to you? This is not very easy scripture, is it? Even sinners lend to sinners, expected to be repaid in full. But love your enemies. Do good to them and lend to them without expecting to get anything back. Then your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High, because he is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful just as your Father is merciful. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. So what is hard about being a Christian? The difficult path is marked by suffering, persecution, delayed gratification, and a regular dying to self. The world's path is much easier because it promises this. It promises as little suffering as possible, acceptance by many, immediate gratification, and the promotion of self. No wonder people want to be more worldly than of Christ-like, because it sounds too cool and, in essence, too good to be true. What does it take to be a Christian? Part of what you just did, getting up and greeting people, even though it was coerced by me, was an initial way for you to be in relationship. I sat toward the middle of the front first seat this morning, and I waited to see who, if anybody, would come and say something to me. And I had people come up and say, "Aren't you sitting in the wrong place?" I've had people saying, "Are you off today?" And some people would say, "That's no different than normal Sundays." And some people came up and said, "You feeling all right?" About 12 people in all did that. Then when I walked up and said what I was doing, you're like, "Oh, okay." But a lot of you saw me, didn't you? But how many of you came over and said something? The interesting part is those that did were surprised that I was there. I wonder if God is surprised by our reactions in this world, how we share our faith, how we share our devotion, how we interact, and to whom we interact with. It's not easy always to share our faith and love with the people that we like. Sometimes we have to share our life experience with people that we don't know. This past Monday, I was driving back from, it used to be called Wreckers, now Get Go. I was putting air in one of the tires because it was a little low. Coming back, there was a pickup truck, a dually sitting on the side of the road with the flashers on, going the opposite direction, actually staying still. So I rolled down the window and I said, "Can I offer you any assistance?" And he said, "No, just things fell out of the bed of the truck and I'm having to retrieve them." And I said, "Well, do you want help getting them?" He said, "No, that's okay, I got the last one." And then out of the patience of my voice, I said, "Well, I planned that well." And he laughed and he said, "Thank you for stopping, though. You don't get that much anymore." It's hard in this world to take a risk, to offer help, because you don't know what's going to happen. But it looked like a very easy thing to offer and to ask. And it's not to tell you that to go, "Oh, our pastor's so good." I would hope anybody would do that. You see, God calls us more to be just attenders on Sunday morning, or occasional at that. But the Bible presents a different perspective about how we should be defined as a Christian. And it says this: a Christian is someone whose behavior and heart reflects Jesus Christ. Now here's the unique piece. It is more important for me to know that you have a deep-rooted spiritual relationship with Jesus Christ than if I see you on a Sunday morning. Well, isn't that a shock for a pastor to say? I'd love to see you on Sunday morning. I'd love to see you every Sunday morning. But I'd much rather you have a deep-rooted, personal, intentional faith, and you live that out into the world, and people passionately see you to make a significant difference. It's not easy being a Christian today with all the institutional, ethical, doctrinal, political, cultural shifts that our world's taking. But God's going to provide a way and a path. My theology, my faith is based on loving Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior, and then loving as many people as possible. Not because of who they are, except being a child of God. I don't want to put any parameters around people. I only like you if you look like me. And thanks be to God, there's only one of me. I'm only going to like you if you believe the same way I do, or you act the same way I do, or you have the same thoughts that I do. I'm going to love you, period. I'm going to love you for who you are, not for what I want you to become. That's not up to me. Again, I'm in sales, not management. I can only pave the path and give you the instruction, give you the information, but it's up to God to change the hearts. So let it be. Sometimes it's not hard at all being a Christian, because I live out what God wants me to do. The only time it becomes difficult being a person of faith is when I try to have my own vision of what God wants. I just know that life is hard sometimes. It's hard whether you're a Christian or not a Christian. But I have found that in my faith, it seems to be a whole lot easier, because I have found the one, the source, that has created a path for me to be like Christ. You see, I don't always walk in the light. I walk in the darkness sometimes. You ever once in a while get confused? This morning, got a phone call at 7 a.m. sharing that Leona's not going to be able to be here today and change plans. So I sent out an email and I thought, okay, I got this. I got the day. I'm running. I went downstairs and finished getting dressed, and I thought, where's my phone? I can't find my phone. So I found my phone, got out into the garage, opened the garage door, and I thought, okay, where's my keys and my wallet? So I go back in, I get my keys and my wallet, and I come back out, and I get going, and I get halfway down my street, and I think to myself, did I shut the garage door? So I turn around, come back, and look. Anyone else done that? Yeah. Thank you. It was shut. So I come to church, and I'm making some signs to put on the door. And for some reason, the printer didn't want to work. And so after a careful, chosen words, please, Lord, let it happen, it printed. So I put those out. And then I come into worship, and you can tell what's happened today. But despite that, we're still able to have worship, aren't we? Despite the weirdness, the oddness, the confusion, the did I remember this? This is Sunday, right? As far as I know, today. We don't know what's going to happen from moment to moment sometimes. So it's best that we try to have things done already ahead. You know, every night I lay my clothes out the night before. I know what I'm going to wear, just in case there's an emergency. And I'm so grateful I actually remembered to put clothing on, and so are you. So I use 4 points to help me in times of my Christian challenge. These are words you've heard before, but I put them in a different frame for me. And these help my formation. And the words are love, hope, peace, and faith. But here's the distinction. Love is the key to open the heart. Hope is the dream which awakens the soul. Peace is the awareness which guides the way. And faith is the certainty which sees me through. The Christian challenge is often felt because we feel inadequate to share ourselves. We're not worthy of God's love, therefore how can we share God's love if we don't feel that good about our Christian faith? Or we do not wish to impose or intrude upon someone else. But God has provided promises. There are a whole bunch of promises in the scripture, but I'm going to give you a holy number. I'm going to give you 7. 7 promises of connection with God. I am your strength. This is God speaking to us. I am your strength. I will never leave you. I have plans for you to prosper. I hear your prayers. I will be present with you. I will give you peace. And the last one is the most affirming one that I know. I will always love you. There is a song, and this dates me a while back, a group called the Imperials. It was a Christian group many years ago, and they sang a song called Praise the Lord. And I'm going to read to you a couple of the verses and then the chorus. When you're up against a struggle that shatters all your dreams, and your hopes have been cruelly crushed by Satan's manifested schemes, and you feel the urge within you to submit to earthly fears, don't let the faith you're standing in seem to disappear. The second verse says, now Satan is a liar, and he wants to make us think that we are paupers when he knows himself we're children of the King. So lift up the mighty shield of faith, for the battle must be won. We know that Jesus Christ has risen, so the work's already done. And the chorus is amply stated. Praise the Lord, he can work through those who praise him. Praise the Lord, for our God inhabits praise. Praise the Lord, for the chains that seem to bind you serve only to remind you that they drop powerless behind you when you praise the Lord. I hope today that in the challenges of your day and the next day and after, that you find peace and comfort and love and hope and faith. So you can be the person that God is calling you to be. And it just may be the energy and the passion that God is nudging you to give may just be what someone needs to hear, see, and feel. Now that scripture in Luke, love your enemies, it's not easy. To give of your coat and don't ask for anything in return. Give something to someone and not expect to receive. I was brought up and raised that if somebody gave you something, the phrase, if it wasn't immediately given by me, My mom and my dad would say, what are you supposed to say? And the answer is, okay, I think we need to train you. If somebody gives you something, you're supposed to say,
thank you.
Okay. You're supposed to return in kind. Doesn't mean you'll get everything that you've given back, but you will get a return. You may want to call it a return on your investment. Well, think of it as a spiritual down payment, touching the lives of others. So in a little bit, I'm going to go and sit in my seat. And I'm going to be one of you. And I'm going to ask that we all be who God wants us to be. In the Spirit of Christ our Lord. Amen.
Wow. That's worship. And let's say thank you to our Lord who loves us so much through song. Would you please stand, turn anywhere you need to. You can sing any words you want, but just it's coming from the heart. Hosanna, praise, Hosanna, praise is rising.
Your presence, all our fears washed away.
It's ironic. Early in the service, I felt compelled to not challenge you, but to thank you. And then I heard the pastor say that. I want to thank you for being here today. I want to thank you for smiling. I want to thank you for sharing your talents, for being so dedicated. I want to thank you, Pastor, Lord, for giving us this pastor who loves you and loves us so much that he wants to make sure we know where we're going. I want to thank you for loving so much. You people are so filled with love. There's no way anybody could not feel that today. So I have all the confidence in the world that you're going out this week and you're going to love just like you do here. And remember, God will love us forever. Don't be afraid to use those words this week. Love you, people. God loves you. Can't wait to see you next week.
When we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Oh, washed away.
Welcome.